I'm Dr. Thaddeus Radzilowski of the Piast Institute. This is the month of March, and this is the month in which those of us who honor the Polish tradition remember the contributions of Casimir Pulaski, who was not only a hero in Poland, but a hero of the American Revolution. He was born this month in 1746. He came to the United States having already had a career as a fighter for liberty. For 4 years, he struggled to preserve the old Polish constitution and to resist Russian encroachment on his beloved Poland. When he left, his cause had been, at least for a time, defeated. But the reason he came to the United States, or what was to become the United States, was that he wanted to continue that battle. He was a man committed to fighting for liberty. He reflected the best of that tradition of the old Polish Republic, a desire for human beings to be free, to govern their own affairs. He loved liberty, and he came to the Americas in order to defend it also. When he left Poland, he went to Paris, and there he met Benjamin Franklin. He told Franklin he would like to come to America to fight. And he said, "Wherever on the globe men fight for freedom, it is as if it were our own affair." And here he reflected an old tradition. For centuries, the great horsemen of Poland, its great cavalry, defended the East against invasions from Turks and Tartars. They knew they were fighting not only for themselves, but they were fighting for the tradition of the West. A famous English writer, G.K. Chesterton, called Poland Antimurale Christianis, the outer wall of Christendom. And nobody represented that old tradition better than did Pulaski. And by coming to fight in America, he gave it a new, modern version. He gave it a version that would be echoed later in the 19th century as Poles, having lost the battle for their own country, went to fight all over the world for the liberty of other people. He was one of the first to establish that. It was his successors who coined the slogan, "For your freedom and ours." And it was Kosciuszko and Pulaski who first made that a reality when they came to fight in America. When Pulaski came, he was already a famous guerrilla leader and one of the greatest cavalrymen in the world. He's the founder of the American cavalry. He even created his own, using his own resources, his own military unit, a combined arms infantry cavalry unit, which one British general said was the best cavalry that the rebels had. He fought for 2 years in both the North and the South for American liberty. In October 1779, he was killed at the Battle of Savannah in an attempt to save a faltering American attack on the city. He led a cavalry charge into the British lines. It was to cost him his life. One of his great opponents in Poland, the King of Poland, Stanisław August, who was almost kidnapped by Pulaski, said of him, "He died as he lived, a great hero, but an enemy of kings." And that really sums up his legacy, an enemy of kings, man who stood for freedom and for liberty. When he arrived in the United States, George Washington said of him in a letter to John Hancock, "This gentleman has been like us, engaged in defending the liberty and independence of his country, and has sacrificed his fortune to this zeal for those objects. He deserves from this a title to our great respect." And I think since his death, Americans have regarded him as one of the founders and one of the authors of our liberty. He died before there was a United States. And fittingly enough, 8 years ago, the Congress of the United States voted him an honorary citizen of the United States. Only the seventh person in the history of the United States to be granted honorary citizenship of a country whose founding he made possible by his courage and his commitment to freedom for all.